Hey, everybody. People who are going to watch this later, because there's no one here yet. Just a quick disclaimer. Don't do this at home. I'm assuming all risk and liability of doing this. It's not 100% safe. So, hey! What's going on, Liz? So, like I was just saying, don't try this at home. It's probably not a good idea, and it's not super safe either. So, if I hurt myself, it's on me. Not, you know, it's nobody else's fault. So, yeah. Cool. So, last week, everybody, I was loading all kinds of crazy stuff, and I asked everybody, what should I load into shotgun shells next? And everyone suggested a whole bunch of different types of candy. And I think I forgot the list. I did. Should probably plan ahead for these things. So I bought a whole bunch of candy. There's a few things I could not find on the list. One of them was Pez. It's really hard to find Pez, apparently. And Pop Rocks. I went to numerous places, like gas stations and convenience stores and dollar stores, trying to find Pez, like all these candies that everyone suggested, and I could not find Pez, and Pop Rocks. So, but I got pretty much everything else. I have Mentos, gummy worms. I actually even have a couple extra things too. I got Smarties. I've got Red Hots, but I also have what's the other one that's called Red Hots? They look like Mike and Ike's or whatever, but they're not Red Hots. Tony, what's the cinnamon candy that I got? Tell me in the comments right here. Tell me the comments. I got some Tic Tacs. Let's see here. Lifesavers. I don't know if Lifesavers are going to fit, honestly. I thought about this, like, after the fact, and I was like, the Lifesavers might be a little bit too big. Then, let's see here. Smarties. I've got Gobstoppers, which I picked up today. Nerds, which was also... these two were surprisingly hard to find. It's like kids don't like hard candy or, Jawbreakers anymore. It's really weird. Got Red Hots and, you know, put all the candy in this bag because I couldn't help myself from eating some of it. And I'll probably eat more of it while we're doing this. See here, I've got a beer. I've got a great attitude, and let's do this. So, let's see here. We're going to get ourselves a shotgun shell. I'm trying not to use these stupid universal shells, because they're not great. So, I've got a regular one right here, and it's not a universal one, that sucks. So, let's put a primer in there. Okay, and so which one should I load first? Any suggestions, anybody? I don't like how that did that. So I'm gonna put this powder back in here. Obviously with reloading, you want to pay attention, which is kind of hard. I mean, I'm paying attention about what I'm doing, but, you know, I'm also talking to a camera. Well, technically speaking, my phone. Really gotta work on that whole thing, you know? I just gotta destroy it from my vocabulary. See? There it is again. Okay, so... down. Powder. Good. Awesome. Let's get ourselves a God. And put it in there. Good. So, which one should I do first? I know there's at least one person watching right now. I don't know who you are. If I just kind of start talking vaguely to whoever is watching, it's because there's really not a whole lot of information down here. It says Liz joined and Tony joined, but there's only one thing up here. I don't know if this is on your guys' screen too, but there's only one person up here. There's like an eyeball with a number one next to it. So, I don't really know exactly who's watching. So, let's see here. Put that back in my wallet. Okay, so we've got the wad in the shotgun shell. Very good. Let's see here. I guess we could start with Mentos. We're making Mentos. Hey, Frank! How's it going, dude? Loading shotgun shells with random candy. I have a whole bunch of candy here. Last week, everyone suggested it. So, we're going to put Mentos in here. And when I actually go shooting, we're going to try and get like a 2 liter of Diet Coke. See if we can shoot the 2 liter with the Mentos and see if we get a really big explosion. Obviously, there's going to be explosions because you're shooting a liquid with something flying out of a barrel. Worst case scenario, it literally bounces off of the Coke and nothing happens and we just dump the rest of them in there. At least try to. I mean, it's going to be a bad time. Either way you cut it. So, Mentos. Mint. The chewy mint. Open this up. Like I was saying last week when someone suggested Mentos, does anybody eat these at all? Like, anybody enjoy these? I don't know. So let's see if this will actually fit in there, and it looks like it may not fit perfectly. So, I was worried about this. So, the shotgun wad fits inside of the shotgun shell, but it also has these little fins. The fins are designed to catch the air when they come out of the shotgun shell. So basically what happens is the shot stays inside of the wad cup until it leaves the barrel, and then the wind resistance catches the wind and splits it open, and so this slows down, but the shot keeps going. All the time. So, I was worried that the wad would take up too much room inside of the shot shell for some of these things. So, what we're gonna have to do is, A, get that wad out of there. I'm drinking Newcastle. Oh, drinking on YouTube. I really hope that doesn't violate some kind of terms an agreement. If it does, I'm sorry. But I'm just gonna keep drinking. So, put that away. And, oh no, I still need that. Or, we'll load something else, and then I'll make another one without the petals on the wad cup. So we'll cut those off right now. And okay, very good. So now we just have basically a piston that is going to propel the shot down the barrel or whatever's in there. So essentially what this does also is it sits on top of the gunpowder inside the shot shell. So this basically keeps the gases and pressures behind the shot as it goes down the barrel. See here. Yeah, that should be good. Looks like it's about the same diameter. It's a Mentos on top of a shotgun wad. Cool. So, let's see how many check out the job stocks to see how many of those we can fit in here. My hope is that these will be about the same size. Some of these aren't even circular. Jesus. Like, this one. It's like half of a gobstopper. Yeah. I guess I'll eat it. I haven't had one of these in a long time. It's good. Huh. So I can fit two of those in there. Oh, man. These are a lot bigger than I remember them to be. I was hoping to find, like, mini gobstoppers. I've seen them before in the past. They do exist. But I was not able to find them. I mean, these were hard enough to find them. The regular gobstoppers. So I was just able to chew that up real good. Like, almost instantly. It's really good. Man, I haven't had one of those in a long time. It's good. I like candy. Candy's good. Do you guys like candy? My wife, Tony, as you guys know, she was telling me that it sounds like a waste of candy. I'm like, yeah, it kind of is. But it'd be fun. You know, that's what we're doing. We're having fun. So, just two, huh? It's kind of a bummer. Oh well. Oh. Crud. Remember that these ones are the 6-star crimp. What's up, Elvis? So there's different types of crimps on I didn't get any Skittles. I saw them, and I didn't get them. I'm sorry. Sorry, Elvis. I failed you. So, 6-star crimp. Anyways. Crimp. I heard a crush. I may have just crushed the things in there. Yeah, a little bit. It does not look like a good crimp either. But that's why we're doing this. It's to see what fits in a shotgun shell. And see what candies will work and what candies don't. 2X gob. Cool. Put that right there with the rest of the random shot shells that we have. And we'll take that off. Put this guy back on. Most of the shot shells that I have are 8-point crimps. Huh. You didn't pay any money for this, Elvis. But if you like to pay money, you could. Because this stuff isn't free. Okay. So, gobstoppers, not so great. Kind of a bummer. But we will sally forth. Let's do a gummy worm. Yeah. That'll be fun. Right? Yeah? Gummy worm? You guys remember that dog from that YouTube video forever ago? That was like, hey, so-and-so, do you want, I just had this really great meal. It was like, it was this and that, and he's like, and then I fed it to the cat. No! You guys remember that? It was fucking hilarious. That was like 2010, 11? Maybe 12? You guys remember that? No? Alright. That's fine. I remember random pointless things. Power in there. Oh, no. Okay, we're gonna use eye brass shell because we need the extra strength. Much remember. Nice. So we're going to need the extra strength for the Mentos. Let's not do gummy bears or gummy worms yet. So, got that in there. Put our wad in. Alright, wad is all the way down there. Hey, Carrie. I'm using the shock loader you gave me for Christmas. Everyone, you can all thank Carrie Anderson right there for this. So, everyone say thank you, Carrie. So, alright. So, put Mentos in a shotgun shell, because why the hell not? Let's go. So, how many can we fit in there? There's one. Where's my Mentos? Here they are. And here's two. I think we might be able to fit three Mentos in here, honestly. So we'll have to weigh three Mentos and see how much they weigh. So we can get a rough idea. Ooh, come on. Come on. Don't be a shit bird. I don't know if we can fit three. I think we're going to have to fit three because now I can't get it out. Okay. So it's like right at the top. So we might have to... 6 point crap. I think we're just going to start this crimp and then just leave it how it is. I don't know. Think I'm gonna have to finish the crimp to its flush because I don't think it's gonna have room. Yeah, I'd say that's good. We're just gonna leave it like that. So that's three Mentos in there. I'm sure if I used, I think I have some 3-inch shot shells in here, like Magnum loads. I think I could fit more in there if I use that. The other option is I can cut the wads down even further so they don't have a shock absorber, because on wads, there's a, you can see right there, it's like a shock absorber. That with lead is there to prevent deformation of the shot when it gets launched down a barrel. And prevents it from getting all deformed and fucking up your accuracy. But we're really not going for accuracy with this shit. We're going for ridiculousness. Oh, I love Newcastle. Alright. I'll have to label that one because it's pretty damn obvious what it is. Because it's sticking out. So we were going to weigh three Mentos, see how much those weigh each, get out my handy dandy scale, turn it on, put the little bowl thing on there, zero it out. So I'll have you know that three Mentos weighs 131 grains. So for people who don't kind of understand the grains situation, that's how bullets are weighed. Like the weight of a bullet is measured in grains. 400 something odd, I think it's like 472 is... an ounce, something like that. Someone else can probably do the math. But your average 9mm bullet is 115 grains, and your average 38 special bullet is, I mean, ideally it should be 158 grains. That's my favorite weight for 38 special because I do shoot quite a bit of 38 special. And behind me, over there, is all the stuff to reload 38 special. And, yeah. So, I bet you... Let's try doing this with that. See if I can get this out of here without knocking you guys over. Also, if we have time today... That's a 10-gauge shot shell. It's a very, very beefy... A dime weighs a gram. Well, I get it now. Maybe I'll do some dimes. Maybe I'll get a roll of dimes one of these days, and we'll see how many dimes I can fit in the shot shell. I should have 3-inch... Yes, I do! 12-gauge, 3-inch shot shells. To do that on this shot shell loader... I have to adjust it a whole bunch. But we might be able to wing it just for a couple shells. So let me see how many of these guys I have. Which I think I have a fair amount. Yes. One of them has a 22 casing inside of them. Okay. Close this very carefully. Don't cut your wad too short. So, how much does 4 Mentos weigh? Grains. So, if we calculate that into ounces. Whoop, that's not what I wanted. Hang on, I just fucked that up. Units to ounces. So that's just, it's 0.4 ounces is 4 Mentos. So, let's see how many we can fit in a 3-inch magnum load. So, to give you an idea, here's a regular shot shell, here's a 3-inch magnum load. It's just a hair longer. So, if I put 3 in here, I could probably crimp this and do, like, it would look maybe factory. But... I could probably do 5. Let's give it a shot. I only bought one roll of Mentos. I was thinking about buying another one. I didn't think they'd go this quick. But let's see. One of these days I'll get a 10 gauge. How many grains in a gram? Do I have a dime on me? Let's find out. Yeah, I do have a dime. So, well, that's grams. A dime actually weighs 2.245 grams. Grams. So, a dime by itself is 34.6 grains. So, we all learned something. Everyone learned something today. So, let's see here. If you just joined us, we're putting Mentos into shotgun shells so that I may shoot them in the future. So everything I shoot will be very, very fresh. Because it's the fresh maker. So, let's put a primer in this shot shell. Very good. We're going to have some problems here. I think part of the reason why they have you adjust the bottom of the shot shell, or the bottom of the reloader thing, is because I literally can't get this to go in the right spot for to receive powder. So what we'll have to do is I will pour powder into this, pour it into here, and we'll go from there. Cue laugh track. I wish there was a laugh track. It would just be constantly going, nonstop. Like, there'd probably also be a constant screaming soundtrack. Yeah. So, powder. Let's get that down there. Over and over. Okay. That gave us all of our powder. And if some of you are curious about how many grains of powder I'm using, too bad. Because I'm not going to tell you how to do this. Because that's not something you should learn from me. Yeah. If you want to reload shot shells, look it up. Do the math. Do the research. It's the smart move. I'm doing this in a way that it will be relatively safe. Nothing about improvised shot shells is safe. But it's safe-ish. Like, it may not 100% kill me. Maybe like 60. Anyways. I may have lost a few grains here and there. But that's okay. So, I have to cut off some of the petals on here, because we discovered that that was impeding the shot shell from accepting a full Mentos, the fresh maker. Okay. So also, I wanted to, if we have time tonight, I wanted to make some wax slugs, because I haven't made any in a while, and I think that I shot all the ones that I made, which was a lot of fun, and they're disturbingly accurate, very cool. For those of you who don't know what wax slugs are, is you take shot from shotgun shells and you mix them with wax, or in my case, crayons. Hey! Those are cheap. And then you pour them back into the shot shells, so when you shoot them, it stays as one piece, and then whatever they hit, they basically dump their kinetic energy. It basically acts like a dead blow hammer, if anybody knows what a dead blow hammer is. And I've seen them go through, like, some shit that's amazing. Like, quarter-inch plate. Like, steel. Just right through it. Punches a hole right through it. It explodes at the other end, but, like, it's just blam! Right through it. Let's see here. See you later, Carrie. Have a good night. Yeah, I could wrap salt in something. Ooh, like a cloth or something. Make a little tiny bag on a sewing machine. I'm pretty good with sewing things, too, so you could do that. Alright, so I'm going to put the wad in the 3-inch magnum shell, and we're going to use my Sharpie, handy-dandy Sharpie. Push that down on top of it. My shotgun will shoot 3-inch magnums, I believe. I'm pretty sure it will. It says 2 3/4. I'm pretty sure it says 3-inch on there, too. If anybody's wondering, I have a Remington 870, which is a great shotgun. If you're looking for a shotgun, that's probably a good option to get. The other option would be a Mossberg 500 or a Maverick 88. The Maverick 88s are a little bit cheaper if you're looking to do it in on a budget, but it's still a fucking great shotgun, and it's almost identical. It's actually made by Mossberg, but it's almost identical to a 500, and it'll take all the same furniture, like aftermarket furniture, as a Mossberg 500, but if you want something that, like, the military uses it, get a Mossberg 500. Or, I mean, the 870s are just as good. It's literally a lateral move from the 500s to the 870s. a little bit of dip down into the 88s, but the 88s are still really fucking great shotguns. So if you're looking for a shotgun, one of those three would be a really great option for you. I don't think you'd be upset or disappointed about it at all. So, and you can find all of those at Precise Shooter in Linwood, Washington. Bing! So, okay. Mentos, going in here. Yeah, the Mossberg 500s are great. So, one Mentos. Yeah. Let's see here. Two. Three. We got three. I don't know if you guys can you see that? Like, I don't know how that's gonna work. I need to get a roll crimper. If you don't know what a roll crimper is, I can explain it to you, and you probably don't. So, let's see if I can find one. Hang on. So, these are slugs for a shotgun. And instead of being crimped shut, like, let me find the most professional looking crimp. Here we go. Like this one, which I don't even remember what's in here. Should have wrote on there what it was. This one says, oh, these are the low bass, low C from the bass strings. So that's a crimp on a regular shotgun shell. Like, this is the type of stuff that you are going to find when you buy shotgun shells. But slugs, you can see them, that's the end of the slug right there, which is basically an 18mm, I believe, bullet. Just it's like 1 ounce of lead flying downrange at, how fast do these ones say they're going? 1600 feet per fucking second, so that's just lightning fast, like, really cool. But they are rolled on the edge, as you can see. So, to hold them in there. And you can get a roll crimper. I think it attaches to a drill bit. Or a drill. Like a hand drill. And you just kind of hold it in there. And it basically just melts it and curls over the plastic. I should probably get one. I'm sure they're on the internet somewhere. If one of you guys want to buy me one, that'd be cool. But you don't have to, obviously. So, fit four in here, just barely. Oh, man, this would be a perfect time for a roll crimp. What? There must be a significant delay from when I say things to when you guys actually hear them. So, because I made that sound effect like a little bit ago. You. So let's see if we can get this to, wait, what crimp do I need for this? 6 point. Ah, I got the 6 point in there. That's cool. Alright, so 3-inch magnum crimping on a 2 3/4 thing. I'm just gonna crimp it a little bit. Yeah, I think that's going to be good enough to hold it in there. Cool. I hope that chambers. If not, we'll see. Okay. There we go. So, now that we know it's really difficult and annoying to work with a... Hey, Jeff Marshall, how's it going? So now that we know that 3-inch shot shells are really difficult to work with, I'm sorry, guys. Let's just not use them. One of these days, I'll just get a bunch of 3-inch shot shells. We'll see what fits in a 3-inch shot shell. I'll set up the whole thing for 3-inch shot shells, and we'll 3-inch shot shell. Fair? Fair. Let's see here. What else do we got? Alright. Got a shot shell here. Let's put a primer in. So last week we did glitter, which was terrible. Glitter is evil. It's the most toxic substance known to man. It gets on everything. Even if you don't want it to. It just does. I don't know how that works. It's magic or electromagnetic cling. Probably magic, though. That in there. Get powder. Powder's in there. See, I don't, like, I was just talking about glitter, now there's glitter on my hand. How does that even fucking work? Ugh! And the wad. Oh. Oh. Go. In. Oh, son of a bitch. Come on. What's your problem, dude? There we go. It's in there now. Okay. So, let's do... Let's do gummy worms. So I got little sour gummy worms. I'm just gonna get another one. Man, those are really stale. They're really stale. They were in the garage for a couple days. In a plastic bag. But they're pretty stale. And they were pretty stale when I got them from the dollar store in the first place. So, we're going to have to play around with this idea. Because I can either curl them up into little, like, spiral balls. Is that gonna fit in there? Not really. Okay. Or I can fold them in half. I might be able to get, like, two in there, folded in half. I feel like they're gonna be too long now. Yeah, this is good. This is working. Yeah. What's up, Dustin? How's it going, man? Loading shotgun shells full of random shit, like candy. Right now we're doing gummy worms. We did Mentos already. Is that all we've done so far? Mentos? I feel like I spent a lot of time on Mentos. Weird. Alright. Yeah, we're trying to do 3-inch shot shells and we didn't turn them on. See, I'm watching this too. And they trust me with federal paperwork. So, closing that up. Is that the right crimp? Am I using the right crimp? No, I'm not. Hey, Greg. How's it going, man? Just, loading shotgun shells. Oh, there's like candy in my crimp starter. Loading shotgun shells with random things like candy. Yep. Alright, so... crimp start! Yeah, that looks like fucking shit. What the... Oh, that's the right one. Alright, whatever. Oof. I don't know how that's gonna work. The gummy worms were, like, right at the top of the shot shell, so... it crimped! We'll see if it, like, pushes out the crimp here in the future. So, how much does 2 gummy worms weigh? Obviously, there's going to be a variance from gummy worm to gummy worm. Everything's getting sugar all over it because of the gummy worms. Unstable, my... What? Okay. Well, hang on. I really need a trash can out here. We talked about this last time, or time before last, or whatever. I need a trash can out here. It's getting kind of messy. Okay. Maybe it was trying to tell me that I'm unstable. Projecting. Okay. Two gummy worms. Hey! Gummy worm. Two gummy worms weighs 124.5 grains. Which is interesting because that's the weight of a 9mm bullet. I'm beginning to see a trend here. Interesting. Okay. It's like, just put a fucking 9mm bullet in there and call it a day, but like, stop trying to put fucking gummy worms and shit. And I'm like, no. So, shot shell. Red crypt starter in there. Good. Alright, primer. So, I did make a page for this, because I think after this video, next week's is going to be on that page, not on my personal Facebook account. I'll just go back to not posting anything and just phantom liking all of your comments and posts in the future. But the page that I made, the Facebook page for this that I made, you should be able to find under Blake Makes. Yeah, I'm going with that. Tomorrow I'll probably send out a page-like request to all of you. And by all of you, I mean everyone but Elvis. Because I'll send Elvis's twice. Just to annoy him. So, next week, the video will be on that page instead of this one. And I'm also going to upload last week's and this week's video onto YouTube, which is not going to be as much fun for people watching it on YouTube because they don't see all your comments down here. They just get all the bullshitting that I talk about and whatevers. I wasn't really paying attention to that. I should probably put that back in there. And then start over. Stuart! How's it going, man? Stuart is a good friend of mine. We go way the fuck back. Yeah. So, years ago I asked Stuart about reloading 38 Special, and he said that he could do it, and you know, I was like, we should reload 200 grain bullets. And he's like, sure, if you can find them. And I did. And, like, years later, obviously, like, recently I found them. But I reloaded a bunch of 180 grain 38 specials. It's a waste of candy! I asked you if you wanted some. Just don't call the candy police on me, okay? I only already have two candy infractions already. If I get a third strike, they'll send me to Candy Federal Prison. Oh, I need a wad in there. All the bars and the cells are made out of candy canes. Really easy to escape. You just lick the candy canes until they dissolve. But they notice that you're doing it, because like they walk by one day and like the candy cane's a little bit eroded. They're like, dude, really? Just eat through the gingerbread wall. I'm like, Okay. So I've been there like twice. It's not that bad. The worst thing that happens to you at Candy Federal Prison is you get diabetes. You get the Wilford Brimley's. So, two gummy worms in here. Okay. So we will pull this guy over. I feel like if I do this, at this point, I could eat some of the gummy worm, and I could probably coil him up this way so he'll actually fit inside of the shot shell, curled up like a little snail thing. Hey, Sonny, how's it going, man? Long time no see. I'm crazy now, and I load shotgun shells full of candy. You want proof? There's a gummy worm in there. So, yeah. So eating that little bit of gummy worm let me roll him up and fit him in there like a little tiny snail. What's up, Lindsay? So, put that guy in there. So I feel like they're going to weigh a little bit less now. But I like where they went, because they actually stacked up like that, leaves me plenty of room inside the shot shell to crimp it correctly. Yeah! Like that. That looks good. Looks like a normal shotgun shell, but there's two gummy worms in there. Hey, you shared my video. Dude, that's awesome. Thank you very much. I really do appreciate that. If anybody else feels like sharing the video, share their friend, show it to their friends and say, like, look at this fucking asshole. Please do. Because it's funny. And, like, yeah. Also, I know that you were watching because I know everything. I can see all of you right now. Yeah, put your pants back on, dude. So, yeah, tell your friends. Gummy worm. Cool. This one is also a gummy worm. Mommy worm. Cool. So, let's see here. I also have Smarties that we can put in here. Hey, Sean, how's it going, dude? Stuart joined again. Welcome back, Stuart. Had so much candy that he's astral projecting. He sees all. You did not miss any cool shit. We put three. Wait, no. Yeah. There's three Mentos in here. I found a 3-inch Magnum shell, which has four Mentos in it, but you can't finish the crimp. So, yeah. Let's see here. I'm eating some Smarties now. Because I want to eat some more before I actually put them in a shotgun shell, because I love Smarties. Again. Trash can. Let's do nerds. Let's all do nerds. And not because it's hip and cool right now. Let's do nerds because we feel it in our hearts and our souls. I didn't find rock candy. Rock candy would be too big. Fresh maker shells, yeah. Yeah, that's what I want to do. I want to shoot the Mentos into, like, 2 liters of Diet Coke. So, I have the most generic nerds you can find, which were actually really hard to find. They've obviously changed the names of them. It used to just be grape and strawberry. You know, no frills. Just, it's grape and fucking strawberry, guys. Come on. But now it's called Gotta Have Grape. Because, you know, like, apparently it's really important. And speaking of really important and urgent, it's Seriously Strawberry. You know, when people say that, like, your childhood is dead, they fucking mean it. Mm. That is some delicious birdshot. Oh. Alright. I gotta open up a new thing of primers now. Okay, put those right there, because that's safe, and primered, Seriously, strawberry. Not fucking around, strawberry. We are seriously strawberry. Okay, wads in there. So I'm curious about how much these nerds are gonna weigh, because this little box of nerds that I just ate some out of, so we're not gonna get an accurate measurement now. How much does this weigh? Oh, overload. So, this is about an ounce. Yes. Wow, I could just look at the fucking packaging and it would tell me 1.65 ounces of nerds in here. That's probably a smarter move to do than try to weigh it on my fucking thing. Alright, smart pants. Let's do this. Should I do grape? Grape or strawberry first? Grape or strawberry first? Thanks for all the likes, guys. You guys are awesome. I'll drink to that. Oh. Grape or strawberry first? Grape or strawberry first? Loading shotgun shells with nerds. For nerds. So, I'm also going to be doing grape, strawberry. Okay, so that's one for grape, one for strawberry. So I'm going to do grape in this hand, strawberry in this one hand. You can't vote twice, man. Come on. Come on. One. This is grape. This is strawberry. We're tied. This is how democracy works, guys. Come on. Too late? Yes, true. If I don't get any more votes, you're going to get Trump. Blood. We don't have any blood. There's no blood. I just ran out earlier today. I had a little bit. I got a paper cut. That was it. That was all I had. Come on, just one person. Which one? Grape or strawberry first? There's one vote for each. The next person that votes anything wins the one. And I'll give you a high five next time I see you. There you go. Strawberry. Thank you, Jeff Marshall. I appreciate it. And Lindsay, thank you. That's three. Cool. So we're doing strawberry first. Eight. Oh, hard. Yeah, you got hoes, bitch. All right. Remember when you eat Nerds when you're a kid? And, like, this whole top part would get so soaked with, like, sugary spit. And all the Nerds would just get stuck in there. You'd have to tear this whole thing apart. You get Nerds everywhere. Your parents would be like, ah! It may have just been me. Some Nerds down the wrong pipe. Turtle power. Alright. So, we're pouring the Nerds in. Okay. Maybe just a touch more. Okay. Well, look for me. Yeah. So, let's weigh the Nerds and see how much Nerds fits into a shotgun shell. I'm hoping that I'm pleasantly surprised. Nope. Pleasantly disappointed. 64.7 grains. And there's some fucking grape in there. There's like two little grape flavor chunks in with all the strawberries. I just dropped some on the floor. What's up, Teebs? Alright. So, we are going to close up our Nerds shot shell. And put the final crimp on it. And it looks kind of dumb. So, there is Nerds in here. Is it backwards for you guys? I believe it's backwards for you guys, and I don't know why. So, there's Nerds in this shotgun shell, which I will shoot at some point in time. I'm gonna label it now, so I don't forget what's in there. Nerds. There we go. Alright. I think I'm gonna just not use the lifesavers. I'll probably just use these to save lives later instead of put them in shot shells. I'll just save these for later. Just put them right in there. Yep. I'll probably completely forget about those and find them like a month later. And they'll be all like gross and soggy. Yeah. Alright, so I need a couple more shot shells. I'm running out of ones that aren't black. I would like to use ones that aren't black because I can actually write on them and remember what the hell they are. Yeah, I know, the lighting in here is not that great either. Let's see here. Titanic birthday cake? That sounds like it would just be a giant disaster. This is where the laugh track would happen, right now. There'd be laugh track. And then screaming for all the people who don't find that funny. So they'd be going off at the same time. Should be nice, juxtapose. So, I guess I will use Let's try another one of these crappy Universal ones. Let's see here. Put it in there. Okay. Nope. There we go. Powder. Wad. You guys are awesome. I'm glad you're here. I'm glad you're all here watching me do this. It's fun for me to see you guys making ridiculous jokes. I'm not taking any of this very seriously. It's fun to me. I'm glad you're here. Thank you for being here. Wad. I'm waiting to a lot of typos. Awesome. Typos are good. Don't worry. I can't type either. I know, man. It has been a good long while since I've seen you, Sunny. Tony and I don't live in in Seattle anymore. We moved to Redmond, and we're living here now. That's how I'm able to do this, because if we were still living in Seattle, we'd be living in a tiny-ass stupid apartment and paying way too fucking much money for it. So, yeah, fuck that. I'm done with it. Yes, virtually hanging out is awesome. I hope to keep doing these, like, once a week. Eventually, I will move this to YouTube, or if anybody else can suggest a better live streaming platform for this, that would be great. I would be very appreciative of that. I just don't have the equipment to even do YouTube right now. I'm doing this all on my phone right now, which is, it's cool, but, you know, thankfully I'm able to hook up to Wi-Fi so I don't kill my, Twitch. Is Twitch cool? You'll have to talk to me about Twitch later, man. I hear you talk about it a lot lately, but I thought that was, like, specifically for gaming stuff. I don't know how this would go over on Twitch. But yeah, I'll probably move this over to YouTube. I do want to keep doing it live. I think mainly I'll be doing this. It'll be always live, I think. There will probably be videos where I Pornhub. Yeah, I feel like I'd have to be doing it naked and no one wants to see that. Thankfully, you can't see me from here down, because then you notice that I'm already not wearing pants. Just let that sink in for a second. Perfect. So, even if I do move it to YouTube, I'll probably just be doing it live, because I don't really want to do a bunch of editing. But if I do non-live video, it's going to be me shooting all this random shit and seeing how it performs ballistically. And for that, I will need a camera person to help me with that. So, maybe one of you? I'm going to burp. You're not seeing half the comments I'm reading? That's weird. Maybe some of you who've set your comment stuff to private. I don't know. So, they're not Red Hots. They are, God, I can't remember what they're called. I think I threw away the package last night. Tony was eating a whole bunch of them. So, these things, they look like Mike and Ike's, but they're the cinnamon flavored ones. They're very strong of the cinnamon smell. Into a shotgun shell. Three of them fit perfectly in there. I think that's all I'm going to get into each one. Yeah, because that fits in perfectly. You can kind of see it. It's really hard to see because they're red things in a red shell. Wait, find me a good camera person for the Pornhub thing or for this? I'm confused now. Well, yeah. So, Red Hots things in there. They're not Red Hots, though. I can't remember what the hell they're called. Anyways, so, crimpity crimp crimp crimp. That one turned out all right. That's pretty good. Yeah. For this, okay, yeah. Maybe, I mean, I don't want anything professional. I can't pay anybody. Yes, I'm going to shoot these shotgun shells out of a shotgun. It's going to be awesome. If you didn't see it, it was from Jeff Marshall. You may have met Jeff Marshall. He used to come into the guitar store quite a bit. He probably still does. I don't know. I'm not there anymore. Awesome guy. Excellent, beautiful taste in gear. Has probably the coolest stuff you can even imagine. And then some. See here. Red. Hot. Spelling. Ike. There we go. Red Hot Ike. Alright, that's just what I'm gonna call him. Because why the fuck not? I'm not doing Pornhub. No. Let's see here. There we go. Okay, and put that in there. Get some shot powder in there. Get ourselves a wad. We'll do another one of those red hot things. They're not Red Hots. God, I wish I remember what the fuck they were called. Let's do some more. Alright. And, oh, that one's like small and deformed. Sad town. Alright. So, put these guys in there. Damn it. Why aren't you doing this? Why? Okay, those ones fit in. Why don't you want to go? There you go. In with your friends. Okay. Perfect. So what should I put in shotgun shells next week, guys? Any questions or any ideas? They're not cinnamon imperials. No, they're not. They're not the dudes that guard the Emperor in Star Wars. Super nerd. BBs? Yeah, I could go get some BBs. Maybe. I think I can get some BBs. I think I can get those at Fred Meyer's. Yeah. Because I think those would work really well because they're actually made out of lead. They're copper-plated lead. So those would actually just be like regular shot. Not as cost-efficient, obviously, but pretty much the same. I'm not doing peanut butter and jelly, Elvis. Or meat. That's gross. Because, I mean, it's going to be a while before I can shoot these, so I don't want, like, a bunch of rotting food with shotgun shells at the same time. Because you have to keep in mind that the powder isn't, like, sealed off from the rest of the shell, so I don't want that stuff getting down into the powder and getting, like, a when I pull the trigger. Let's see here. Let's do some Great Bites, which is a Tic Tac ripoff brand. Thank God for dollar stores. Oh, that's cute. The cutest thing about these Tic Tac ripoff is they're called Great Bites. I know that's backwards for you, but you can get it. There's a shark there, and it says called Great Bites. Won't this gum up your barrel? No, because I'm not shooting gum. But the cutest thing about these guys is they have a little bite out of the package. Like a shark bit them. So let's see how many fit in the shotgun shell. Blue! Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah. Trying to find a decent shotgun shell. Alright, there we go. No, technically, I mean, in all seriousness, they won't. I don't know if you could see Jeff Marshall's comment, but he said, won't this gum up your barrel? And, no, it's just, in all seriousness, the wad protects the barrel, mostly from shells, from whatever is coming out of them. The ones that I've cut the wadding off, I'll just shoot, like, a normal shotgun shell after them, and it'll, like, clean the fuck out the barrel. So, oh, you can see it now, cool. So, I'm not super worried about it. The cool thing about shotguns, too, is that if I really fuck up the barrel somehow, like it's ruined on the inside, messed up or whatever, I can just buy a new one. It's like $80, something like that. And they're pretty much drop in. I just take the old barrel off, put the new barrel on, and I move on with my day. Which is totally cool. And they're cheap. Like it's not gonna be that big of a deal. So, alright, I gotta put powder in this guy. And wad. There we go. So, funny you should say that, Lindsay. We did that last week. They are these guys right there. I have a couple shot shells loaded up with that. I also did one with these tiny glass marbles, which is actually just like teeny tiny little glass beads. And I'm honestly a little bit terrified of that one because it's glass. So, yeah, we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Alright. Great Bites. Let's put you into some shot shells. Well, they're shaped like little tears. I don't know why they're shaped like, maybe they're supposed to be shaped like teeth. Maybe it's because people like to avoid you knowing what they're saying almost. I don't know. Can everyone share their comments with Elvis, please? He's starting to feel a little left out. Thank you. Kids play nice now. So, got the wad in there. Okay, how many of these fit in there? Hey, they kind of organize themselves in a really cool way. They seriously do that? Okay, so these guys, these little Great Bites, are organizing themselves in threes, like, with hair next week? I could do that. I don't think, The hair would be a problem, because that'll be like a really, really light load, and it's just not going to do anything. Unless it's like hair mixed with wax, which might be interesting and gross. Maybe three more. There we go. Cool. So, I just did a bunch of these great bites. Worms would be a little bit too inhumane. I don't know how I feel about launching creatures out of shot shells. I don't know about that one. I like where you're going. I like the ideas. But not worms. I mean, I can shoot gummy worms. So I've already got some loaded up. But let's see here. Great bites. Okay, there we go. So let's do another one of those. I'm curious about how much those little dudes weigh. It was 4 layers of 3, so that's 12 of them. So I've got 5, 10, 11, 12. So turn my scale on. Ooh. I lost one, but I found it. And I also just found a bottle opener, which I very well could have used earlier instead of the one in my wallet. So we will hold on to this, put that right there. I don't know what this is. I think this is actually an outline of my property. So that's kind of cool. Yeah, neat. So put a little dish there, zero it out. 82 grains is how much the little things weigh, the great bites, Tic Tac copies. Legos? So, funny you should say Legos. There is a video on YouTube by a couple dudes where I haven't done rice yet, no. I did popcorn seeds, like popcorn things and salt, but I haven't done rice yet. Let me try rice next time. Good idea. Anyways, Lego guy heads, the little Lego guy heads, they are actually 40 caliber. So you can load those into a 40 caliber bullet and shoot them with like 2 grains of powder, and they actually get going pretty fast, about 400 feet per second. So, because they weigh like, they're like 8 grains or something like that, each little dude head. So, if anybody has a 40 caliber handgun, and you want to shoot Lego dudes out of your gun, you can. Like, they actually engage with the rifling and everything. Like, they are perfectly sized 40 caliber Lego heads. Pretty cool. So, I'm going to try a hair less in this one. Oh, no, I need primer first. I'm getting ahead of myself here. So, in the future, I won't always be loading shot shells. I do other things in the channel. This whole situation is going to be called Blake Makes. So, I do have CO2 canister probably work. I think those are perfectly sized for the inside of a shot shell. I wish I had one around here. test that out. I feel like I just saw one, like, a little bit ago. I want to get some mini Bic lighters, too. That would be pretty cool. I think that would work pretty well as well. There's a bunch of screws in this here drawer. I feel like I saw a CO2 canister just the other day. Wow, that is one giant ass rubber band. The wallet chain. Washers. Here's a dice. Is that gonna fit in there? No. Alright. Let's see here. Anyways. Where did I see that CO2 canister? Anyways. Lot in there. What time is it? Anybody know? This whole thing prevents me from seeing what time it is, and I don't have a alternative clock. Load these three at a time. It's cool that these little great white Tic Tac things organize themselves. Man, come on. There we go. Wood glue and sawdust? That might be pretty cool. But then why wouldn't I just get a wood dowel for shooting at vampires? Maybe I should get some wood dowels. I think that'd be pretty cool. The problem with that is I'd have to put, like, something in the bottom of them to give them some weight. Like, wood dowels with, like, a lead sinker from fishing in them. This is the symbol for fishing, apparently. Fuck. Alright, so those guys in there. And yeah, these ones are kind of fucky. So, flaxseed, so that when I shoot at something, it stays regular. Alright. What haven't I put into a shot shell yet? Soup beads? What do you mean soup beads? What do you mean? I don't know what that is. Like bouillon cubes? Oh, soap. So, that's another thing about my phone is that the screen is totally cracked, like, everywhere. So, it looks like I'm looking at myself through a spider web, which is kind of cool. Bouillon. 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 Do you guys know how to say good morning in Russian? Dobre rucha. Yeah, that's how you do it. So if anybody's watching in Russia, Dobroye Ucho. The benefits and interesting things about working for Russians. And Smarties. Smarties. Let's put some Smarties in there. Let's do it. I'm kind of disappointed that the Gobstoppers don't work. I bet you anything, if I found mini Gobstoppers, they would totally work. But, alas, I did not. Everybody's week going okay? You know, everybody's having a good week so far. I just finished my week. Today was my Friday. So I got to do this when I got home. I got home and Tony and I ate some food and hung out for a little bit, watched the TV. And then I came out here to do this. She probably watched a little bit. She's probably in bed right now. Going to sleep. She's got to work early tomorrow. And yeah, but so far, so good. I did not do M&Ms. Good point. I bought mini M&Ms. And I didn't do actual Red Hots. Original cinnamon candy Red Hots. A chain link would work. They have to be small. Yes, it's very true. That might work. Yeah. The hardest thing is, like, if you really want to do this right, you really got to organize things in here. Because there's really not a lot of room inside a shotgun shell, to tell you the truth. One, two, damn it, motherfucker. Ah! Come on. Okay, no. So this is kind of difficult. There you go. Awesome. See, everyone's on the same page, and it's good. Trying to avoid dropping too much food on the floor, because I feel like if I drop enough food on the floor, there'll be like instantly rats everywhere, which will not be fun for anybody. Really tiny shotgun shells from action figures? Oh my god, that would be fucking hilarious. If someone can find me tiny shotgun shells from toys on the internet somewhere, please send me a message on Facebook about where to buy those. Because if I can find those, I will definitely put them in a shotgun shell and shoot them and laugh my fucking ass off. Please find those. Go! That is your mission. Smarties are apparently too smart for me. Ants? I'm not gonna shoot ants. No living things, guys. Come on. Alright, there we go. Perfect. Okay. Besides, it's really hard to keep ants inside of a shotgun shell. So, Elvis, I did make a bolo round of some sort. Did you just, like, copy and paste something from Wikipedia? No. Anyways, I did make a bolo round. I made it out of two Hollow Point 38 specials and some bass string that I cut off my bass at band practice, when I changed my strings at band practice. So, done and done. That is somewhere around here. I'm pretty sure I labeled it. Okay, Smarties are dumb, and it's really annoying me. So I'm just gonna grip this and stop fucking around with it. Great. We'll just smash the Smartie in there. Yes, they would. Smarties. Alright. Smarties, better for eating, not shot shell loading. So, mini M&M's. Remember when these first came out, guys? Remember when they first came out? We're all like, oh my gosh, mini M&M's are gonna be so good. And then you remember... they're just M&M's and they're not that very good. So, this whole container contains... yeah, I know, Elvis, I made it out of two 38 special bullets. They're 158 grains each. And I took the base string and crushed it in the cavity of it so that they would fly together. Were you here for that? I feel like you were here for that when I did that. I feel like you were here. So, mini M&M's. Let's do it. I feel like if I'm gonna keep loading black shotgun shells, I'm gonna need to get like a silver pen or something like that. Cause that's like basically all I have left. I have all these like these horrible universal ones, which I fucking hate. Because they, every time I try to do one, they end up looking like total shit. So the Great Bites are pushing out the, hey Allison, how's it going? They're pushing out the crimp, so they're not really working out too well in there. Alright, there we go. Putting a wad in. Float a battleship, like one of the tiny little battleships from the game Battleship. Was that how much whiskey you drink? Because that's not a whole lot of whiskey. And then when it sinks, you'd be like, you sunk my battleship. Everywhere. Vomit. Alright, so if you're just joining... like Allison, we are making shotgun shells with candy in them instead of lead. Right now we're going to do mini M&M's. I don't feel like a whole lot of these are going to fit inside of the shotgun shell. No, not really. No, not a whole lot in there. But that's okay. Yes. I sunk a lot more than your battleship. Nerf pellets. Scooped or shaved from Nerf ammo. You feel weird watching me? That's okay. You feel weird watching me with six other people? Yeah. I did this last week. I made some shotgun shells. Made all kinds of weird shotgun shells. Some with popcorn and salt and other things. This week we did candy off of people's suggestions. So, right now I just put in some mini M&Ms into a shotgun shell. So, crimp that up. And done. As much as I don't like the black shotgun shells, like, they work the best out of all of them. It's true. Everyone should just take their pants off while watching me. It's just probably a lot more fun. And it's okay to drink, because I'm drinking too. So, I'm not drinking alone, because you guys are here. Because if I was drinking alone, that'd be sad. But I'm not, because you guys are here. And now I wish I had another one of these. Take a little bit of vape break here. I just realized I haven't vaped at all since I got out here. Do it. Get a beer. Fishing. Okay. I think I'll do one more shot shell with candy in it. So, my idea for testing these out is to go out in the woods, because no range in the right fucking mind will let me shoot a bunch of candy shotgun shells. Because they probably don't want ants or rats either. And there will be fucking candy everywhere. Sonny, did you seriously find tiny little shotgun shells? Like, how small are they? That, oh man. If you found them, that's a fucking, oh, yes, I'm going to buy those and put them in there, probably when I get paid next. That's awesome. Like, how big are they? Like, teeny tiny? Or, like, you know, like, Tic Tac size? And then is there a ton of them? Because that would be hilarious. I lost my train of thought when I saw your Facebook message up there. Yes, what I was going to do when I go shoot these. So, I want to go to an outdoor range and set up like a target with like maybe a plywood backstop behind it. So, we can see the hits on the paper, but if anything makes it through the plywood at all, or makes a sizable dent, we'll know that, like, that would suck to get shot with. 8 for $10? Eight of the little tiny shotgun shells for $10? That's insane! I was thinking like a big old bag of them, you know, for $15. But we'll see. I'll check them out. Maybe I'll buy them just for shits and giggles. I wonder if it's enough to fill up a shot shell. So on a more dangerous side, I was doing a little bit of research, and I found out that number one, or single-aught buck, thank you, sir. You're doing us all great credit. Single-aught buck is the same size as a 32 ACP round. So, I bought 132 ACP rounds, and these are cheap. They're like $14 for normal, like retail. Obviously, because I work at a gun store, I got them for cheaper. Tax would be fun. I want to go to, like, where do you get fishing supplies these days? You know? Like, tackle supplies. Because I would assume that they just have, like, bins of lead sinkers that you can probably just buy by the pound. And that would be pretty cool to load in the shot shells. I'm sure that'd be more like a traditional shot shell, but, like, you know. I would also like to load shotgun shells for actually shooting things. Not animals, mind you, because I don't hunt. But, you know, shooting paper and targets and stuff like that with actual shotgun shells. Which I have a ton of. So, you know. The fishing store? Duh. What fishing store, Elvis? Is there a store called The Fishing Store? If not, James Schultz should get on that. I think that would work well. He should just own the chain of the most generic sounding stores ever. Like, for instance, The Guitar Store, and then The Fishing Store, and then maybe The Pet Store. If I could ever convince him, The Gun Store. That'd be hilarious. Let's see here. So, three of those little dudes fit in there. I'm gonna see if I can fit one in there with, the Sarcasm Store. I think that's right. Right here. So, make it bigly. Jeff, if you ever want to come shooting with us sometimes, you let me know. If any of you want to come shooting with me and my buds when we go shooting, let me know. You're more than welcome to come. Even if you've never shot a gun before, I won't make you shoot a bunch of candy rounds unless you want to. In which case I might have to make some more because I probably will have shot these by then. But if anybody wants to come shooting, come shooting. Allison, yes, please do. Maybe you'll convince Tony to come out with me sometime. I've been trying to get her to come with me shooting so many times. And I think if you come with her, she'll be stoked. So the 3 32 ACP rounds in here. I'm going to fill it up with salt as a buffering material, which kind of keeps things together-ish. Whoop, that might be too much salt. I don't want to pour that back in there, because that's touching lead. Bring them out, Jeff, and we will show you how to shoot them. Elvis just recently joined the shooting crowd. And he had a bunch of stuff. And, you know, we brought him out. We went shooting. It was a hell of a lot of fun. Buying a lot of Mauser cartridges soon. We need to go back out to the spot. Hopefully have my shotgun by then, too. Sweet. Cool. I'm totally in. I want to go shooting. It's been a while since we went last time. I definitely want to go shooting soon. Alright, I'm going to close up this one with the 32 ACP. And the salt. There we go. And I'm just going to put these over here. There we go. Alright. I'm eating another gummy worm. I know it's really, really stale. But it's still delicious. Mm-hmm. All right. Red Hots. We haven't done these yet. All right. It's probably not the smartest move that I'm eating candy when handling dirty shotgun shells. I should probably not eat while doing this. That would probably be a smart move. I think I just saw a piece of fucking glitter. Have I told you how much I hate glitter? Glass shards. That does not sound like fun. I just put a primer into this shot shell, and it was super loose, and I was just pulled it out with my fingers. So that's not cool. Alright, here we go. I don't know where it went. Well, there it is. Okay. New shot shell. In you go. No, that's staying in there. Good. Okay. That's kind of a bummer, because it was one of those really cool high brass shells that I like. I am three steps ahead of you. I got glitter in here. It, individual fake teeth. Tony does have weekends off with me, kind of. So Tony has Saturday and Sundays off. I have Friday and Saturdays off. So, a Saturday would be ideal of going shooting. I think that'd be the best part. No, Tony, I work on Sundays. And so, I have all the guns. I don't have anything too crazy fancy. Just a bunch of revolvers, a semi-automatic pistol, which I carry every day. This one. And for those of you who don't know, it's a CZ-75 P-01. 14 rounds of magazine plus one in the chamber. I've been carrying this for a little over a year now. And it's pretty awesome. Alright, so got that in there. Got powder, got a wad. What was I gonna do? Red Hots. Yes. So the Red Hots appear to be made out of cinnamon. Mm. Oh, the one at the store. Yeah. You should just get it. Red Hot seem to be about the same size as normal M&Ms. Or maybe just a little bit bigger than mini M&Ms. I don't think I'm going to be able to get a whole lot of Red Hots in here. This one, I think Red Hots was suggested by Pam. I don't know if Pam is watching this right now. If you're not watching this, Pam, and you're watching it later, I'm doing it. I got the Red Hots in here. We're putting the Red Hots in. Okay. So, I think that's going to be about as many as I can fit in there. Nope. Almost used the wrong crimp. There we go. So, I feel like I was saying this earlier. I won't always be... That didn't fucking work very well. Whatever. Doing shotgun shells. I won't always be doing shotgun shells. This is... It's called Blake Makes. I make all kinds of weird things. I have some electronics projects I need to do. Like, I have to build a foot switch for my giant fuzz head pedal thing so I can control it a little bit easier band practice. I do need to rewire a couple cabs that I'll probably have to bring home to do that. And I will build a ginormous suitcase synthesizer drum machine noise making insanity ridiculous things. I've got all of the parts, I think. No, I need to get like 50 something on toggle switches still. And a fuck ton of solder and wires. So I have to do that. Eventually this whole garage area is going to get remodeled too. Red Hots. There we go. My whole plan about this for the garage, and I don't know if I'll make a video of that or not, because that'll be a really long video. It'll be like an 8-hour video of me doing that. Like, for a couple days, too. I'll probably have to take some time off work, but essentially what I'm going to do is, this is just a garage. I am literally in a garage. It was walled off several years ago, and it kind of holds heat in here, but it's still cement floor. So what I'm going to do is I'm probably going to raise the floor up with, like, a false floor, like, make it out a frame 2x4 floor and put plywood over that and then carpet and everything like that. And basically turn this into a giant living room / creative space for Tony and I and my mom and whoever else wants to come over and make cool stuff with us who also can deal with our dogs. But right now, this is literally full of everything from my apartment. And it is kind of a mess in here. Like, the corner, the view that you see me in is the clean corner. Like, it's, I've got this bench here, and I've got this bench here, which I made in, I know, the dogs love you, Elvis. They do love you. I made this bench because I got a bunch of more reloading equipment for 38 Special, and I had nowhere else to put it. I needed to mount it to, what's up, Ryan? I had to make a reloading bench to load a bunch of 38 Special, and I didn't have anywhere to do it, and I needed to make a bench. So I made this bench in 2 hours, and you guys will get to see that eventually. I might do a video of me loading 38 Special. It's a little bit more intensive, and I can't really just talk the entire time I'm doing that, because I really do have to pay attention to that, because that will probably blow up more violently at me than a shotgun shell will. Because I'm loading bizarro things into them. Just put some Red Hots into one, and I've done everything else weird too, but they're all under what I'm loading for, so theoretically it should be safe. And like I said at the beginning of the video, don't do what I am doing. It's not, if I blow myself up, it's my fucking fault, not yours, not anybody else's. It's because I wanted to do something stupid. So, and I accept that. But, you know, 38 Special, I don't have a chance to load something weird in them, so. Yeah. Let's see here. What time is it? Someone tell me what time it is. Anybody? Time? Time at the tone will be... So I've been standing here for a while. I feel like I've been standing here for a while and talking. And I'm very happy that you guys have taken your time out of your day to come hang out with me. 11:53. So I've been out here for 2 hours rambling. I started at 10 o'clock. and it is almost midnight. I kind of wanted to make some wax lugs. Just so you guys could see that process. I don't know how well that process is going to come across on video, at least with this rudimentary setup. I know seeing me vape is so much fun. Let's see here. What to do? You know what? Fuck it. Let's make some shot. Like, some wax slugs. Let's fucking do it. So, I may have to move you. That is probably gonna have to happen. So, I apologize for any disorientation. Would you use wax beads or wax or shavings? Actually, hang on a second. Crap. I'm actually unsure of where my wax went. So I will have to find that. I put it somewhere. Where did I put the wax? Ah, I found it. So, I actually have quite a bit all ready to go. If we go shooting, we'll probably end up shooting in, like, the woods. So, earlier in the day, the better. So, if you can get a Saturday off, let Tony and I know, and we'll figure something out, Allison. Because I would love to go shooting with you. I think that'd be a lot of fun. I think Tony would have a lot of fun, too. So, this tray is full of numerous... Oh, that's so bright. There we go. Yeah. It's all kinds of different colors of crayons. Crayons, Crayola crayons. So I actually need to break this up a little bit, because the last time I made wax slugs, it took a while for it to melt. Like, it took a good half hour for this to melt. So if I break it up into chunks, it'll get the heat better. This is also slightly dangerous because wax has a smoking point, and then it also has a flash point. So, yeah, totally. But let us know. We'll go shooting. It'll be fun. And I'm sure Tony will love to hear from you too. But, yeah, wax has a flash point, and that's something we want to avoid. We want to get it just to the smoking point, but not any more than that. We want it to be liquidy, like really runny and watery and liquidy, but not fire. Fire is bad. Especially in here, surrounded by gunpowder. Not a good idea. So, the other thing that we have to do to make wax slugs is we have to do a bunch of prepping for them. So, I think I've got enough shot in this where I probably don't need... I wonder how this is going to work. Because I probably don't need to do Play-Doh. I could do that. Play-Doh shrinks when it dries, though. That's the problem with Play-Doh. So, when it dries, it would probably just rattle around inside the shot shell. But, if I get some Play-Doh, I will definitely give it a shot. Let's see here. How am I going to do this? Let's give this a shot. Okay, so what I will do is I will load up a shot shell with a wad and everything. And we'll try to do the crimp. Let's see here. Without stuff in there. What's up, Kyle? Okay. I like how we went from, like, non-lethal candy and shotgun shells. No, not doing food and shot shells. Everyone wants to see me do food, and I don't want a bunch of rotting food hanging out and being gross. Candy is a whole other thing. Okay, so I think I need the right. Yes. Take that off, put that over there. Okay. Let's see here. Ryan, why won't you just say that in the chat here, bud? Okay, so yeah, dude. Give me a holler when you get off work, dude. Alright, so I have this thing. And it is made by a guy in Virginia, I want to say. Ryan is sending me messages in Facebook Messenger. Because you just comment on the video. You just do a comment on the video. You just say, "Hi, I'm Ryan. I work with Blake. I get to hear him ramble all day long, but yet I'm still here." So, shot shell prepper. This is actually designed to cut out the crimp of a shotgun shell, specifically for making wax slugs. And the guy who makes it in Virginia is really, really cool. Sells them for like $35 shipped. It is made out of hardwood, handcrafted. Like, he makes these himself one by one. And I think it's called Mountain Storm. If you look him up on YouTube, he's a really interesting guy. It's Mountain Storm. Or you just look up shot wax slug shot shell prepper on YouTube and you'll find this guy's channel. Because he is pretty much the only guy. He is the only guy who makes these. And they're very well sought after. I was stoked enough to get one. And I'm very happy with it. So, let's see here. See if I can get this to work without shot shells in there. Ah, not really. Fuck. Let's see here. No, it's really not working. Yeah, it's not going to be a good. I might have to really just do this a whole different way, which is okay. Let's see if it'll work that way. It's just turning out real shitty. Okay. That just turned out really shitty. I think I just really fucked up that shell. So, that's okay. So, what we will do is I will take this. Yeah, this is basically just a wax puck full of shot. It's really, really heavy. Take that. Take it out of there. I've got this tin again. Put these little tiny shavings back in here. And we'll do this how you're supposed to do it, say if you just bought a shot box of shot shells. So, let's see here. Yeah, close enough. Cool. So, we have a box of shot shells that I acquired today. They're made by Remington. They are all fucking brand new. So you take your shot shell, and inside this hole there's a razor blade. And what the razor blade is, it cuts the center of the crimp out of these, so you can just dump the shot out. And you stick it in there, and you twist it around, and it to twist it around a bunch of times, and it fucking fails you. This works perfectly every fucking time. Brian, you just, when you're in the video, you just comment on it. Like, below the video, there's just a little comment area. When you're watching it, you just comment there. It's super easy. Well, and then you oh. What's up, Vince? Making wax slugs now. It was in the case for your pedal board? The whole, didn't I tell you to check there? Like, that's awesome. I'm glad you found it. Alright, so that in there. Okay, try this one more time. I may have to adjust this. Edible shotgun shells? I was thinking about making candy shotgun shells. Yeah, that'd be cool. Like, where it's actually made out of chocolate and stuff. So, Vince, funny you should say that. Sunny, who's also in here somewhere, found little tiny shotgun shell, like toy shotgun shells that I'm going to put inside of shotgun shells and shoot them. So, I'll get those eventually, and we'll do that. I might have to adjust this, because this is not really cut and shot the crimp out of these very well. So, that's the cool thing about this thing, is it's also adjustable. So, you undo these screws here. And you can scooch the whole thing up. Ham shells? No, I'm not putting food inside of them. We've already been over that. Okay. Unscrewing things. Jeff Fielder, how's it going? We're making shot shells and stuff. We've been making shot shells for like 2 hours now. We've put all kinds of candy into shot shells. And now we're going to make some, a little bit more, a little bit more lethal shells and Mentos and candy and shots. such. Okay, there we go. Alright, so as you can see, it's literally just a razor blade inside of there, which is super cool. Everybody knows how much I love razor blades. That's probably good. Right. That would be. Yes. Perfect. Perfect. Okay. So now I gotta put this back on. I feel like I should do one more while I still have it out. Yeah, okay. Alright. Then he says to push it down. So it stays in place. And then screw it all back together. Which I will do now. Alright, Kyle, have a good night, dude. Miss you too, dude. We'll have to get together and hang out soon. Get a beer. Can I put a Glock in a shot shell? I think that would be an insult to the shot shell. I don't know if you guys got me like a bunch of tiny little Glocks. Like from toys. I would definitely do that. Like tiny little toy Glocks from like action figures. I would totally put them into a shot shell. Explosive ammunition legal. I'm not a lawyer and I cannot tell you that. Glock is exploding ammunition. Is it really exploding ammunition? Is it? Okay. There we go. So, what you get after it cuts it out is these tiny little star dudes that are the center of the crimps. So it's pretty cool. Let's see. There we go. So it's three. Four. We'll do five shot shells wax. Because that'll be fun. I feel like just because there's so much immense pressure with shotgun shells that it wouldn't droop, it would just explode. Like if it was a really light alloy, I honestly just think it would explode versus just droop. That would be bad. Because then you have like metal flying everywhere and people are crying. Okay, I lied. We'll do 10 wax slugs. I have some more wax somewhere. I can use crayons too. Do you guys want me to use crayons or man, that got all fucked up, huh? Crayons or candle wax. You guys be the choosing. I'm Mr. Susan you do the choosing. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Three more. Crayons. Okay, that's one for crayons. As I know your guys' track record with voting, this is going to take a while. So, when you adjust it out, you just put the shot shell in there, and you spin it around. I smelled it because it felt weird. And you just spin it around, and it just cuts out the center of the crimp of the shot shell. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. One more. Anybody else? Crayons or candle wax? Candle wax might be nice because you can, I'll probably be able to see through it. You could just gerrymander and make my vote count more. That is true. I could do that. 10. Okay. So, never seen shotgun shot. That's what it looks like. This is number 8 shot, so it's actually quite small. So, since you guys aren't voting, this is a democracy, it now turns to a dictatorship. So, I'm going to use candle wax. So, I have this lovely pink candle wax, so I will chop this up into some pieces, and we'll start melting it. Oh, this is going to be lame. There's a piece, there's another piece. Trick is to get the wick out of it. Apparently I was hitting it just a touch too hard. There we go. Got the wick out. Come on. This isn't really working all that great, huh? There we go. That might be enough for now. Okay. What's up, Carson? Welcome to the weird thing. stuff. Let's do some blues in there. Let's do blue and cerulean. Fancy. Homeopathy pills. So a while ago, when I first started making shot shells, I had to hand cut the crimp off of them with a pocket knife. Every single one. And I made a lot. The downside with that is I think I pinched a nerve in my finger permanently. And every once in a while, my finger goes completely numb now. Which is not good. I'm not stoked about that. But, whatever. You know. That's how shit goes. You do something, you are dumb about it, and then figure out an easier way to do it. You know? Seems easy enough. And sometimes it is. Other times, you start doing something and you severely injure yourself, and you're like, well, fuck, that was a dumb fucking idea. And then you regret it for a good long while. But that's okay. Because that's life, man. That's how shit goes. I'm just getting the paper off of these wax crayons. We don't need no stinking paper. We don't need paper where we're going. Okay. So, I have a heat lamp over here. I'm going to get this wax far away from that heat lamp. And same with all this stuff. Anything that I don't want to get absurdly hot. There's just a bunch of random shit everywhere. I really gotta clean up in here a little bit more. I just gotta get a little bit more organized. So, give me just a sec. I gotta plug in this lamp. Alright. Cool, man. Thanks for stopping by. I'm glad this was fun. So now I am letting the heat lamp melt the wax. So this can take a little bit of time. So I'm only doing 10 shot shells, wax lugs, whatever you want to call them, tonight. I'll do more later if you guys want to see more of that. It's kind of a fun way to make stuff. Close that. It's a fun way to make an improvised shotgun round that is cheap. Cheap, cheap, cheap. Like, you can get a box 25 rounds of shotgun shells for $6-7, sometimes $5, something like that. And, you know, if you're hunting birds, that's fine. That's pretty much all you need. If you want something a little bit more, with a little bit more power, say you're going to be hunting something else, and you need a little bit more power, that's a great improvised shotgun load. If you can't afford slugs, but you got a bunch of bird shot, you can definitely do that. You could do it with, you don't have to use wax. I've heard of people using hot glue, which is cool. And Also, I think people have used epoxies too because they really want it to stay together. Yeah, so you could go either way. Or, you know, there's also other people who, if you have a way to melt down lead and remold it, you can make your own slugs out of the shot. You just pour out the shot, make a slug out of it, and you're done. So the wax is melting right now. I was thinking earlier that I should have bought, what was it, gummy worms or something? Or, I don't know, something, taffy. I don't know. So I could make taffy slugs, melt the taffy down on the heat lamp, and do that. Mix it with a shot. That'd be kind of cool. So the wax is melting. This is probably the most exciting part of the live stream. It's getting pretty late, huh, guys? We'll see if we can do this pretty quick. Unfortunately, I have to wait for the wax to melt. I don't think I cut it into small enough pieces for melt quickly. Like, the crayons have melted very quickly. The candle wax, it's really starting to go now. I can see it. So, let's see if you guys can see this.
Okay. So, there we go. See me. So, there's the pan, the aluminum pan, with wax in there. Move this real quick, so you can kind of see. You can't really see anything like that, can you? So, there's the wax, and everything is melting. It's getting there. So, I'm doing it with a... Let's see if...
Hey, well, that's better. Kind of. A little bit. So, it's melting. We're getting there. We're going to stir it around with my spoon that I have specifically for this. That blue looks really cool in there. It's very, very, very blue. Let's hope that the pigment does everything. Hopefully the pigment from the crayons colors the entire thing like a nice cool blue. It's really taking a while, huh? Now we're down to two people. I don't know. What do you guys think? Should we call it a night? So I feel like the wax... If we were going to make wax logs, we probably... should have started doing this like an hour ago. Yeah, let's call it a night, guys. It's like probably 12:30 at night. You guys probably all have work tomorrow. And that's totally fine. We'll do the wax lugs some other time. Maybe we'll do some wax lugs next week. Yeah, could probably do it next week. Yeah, let's call it a night. We'll do the wax slugs next week, guys. And yeah, we've been doing this for 2.5 hours. Yeesh. Yeah, next week, wax slugs. Oop, I just spilled freaking mini M&Ms everywhere. I'm not putting those back in there. Alright. You guys, thanks for joining me on making candy shotgun shells. Next week, we'll do wax slugs. We'll figure out what else, please bring candy to work. Okay. I'll bring the candy to work. Next week, I will, we'll do wax slugs next week. Lots of them. A whole bunch of them. Cool. Thanks for coming. Thanks for hanging out, guys. Have a good night. And, yeah. I gotta figure out some kind of, like, tagline I say when I leave. Like, you're beautiful just the way you are.